So in basically the full project is like what is the difference between full project and quick project? So full project is something just like as a container which will include all the different type of sourcing event. So as we discussed, if you remember that there are different type, four types of events are available in the SAP Ariba sourcing. That first one is the RFI, RFP, reverse auction and forward auction. So whenever we have to create that any like all the like types of event in a single project, so in that case we have to create that full sourcing project. And whenever we have to create like a particular like a event type, so in that case we have to create the quick project. So that is the something basic difference between that full sourcing project and the quick sourcing project. And I think we also have created one sourcing project as well, but I'm unable to find out because this is the demo site and we can see a huge number of the sourcing project has been created in this site. So let me just quickly create, like fill this information. So, and we'll proceed further. Like I think we discussed like inside that up to team. So we talked about the team and we'll discuss further. So give me just one second. Let me give the basic information. So let me just give this name. First, I will give this sourcing and we are creating this RFP, right? So I will take this RFP test project. No, and let me give some value here. ACFA speak. Rest of information are optional. I'm just skim this information and we'll take one template here. All right, so this part already we discussed, like when we are creating this like full any quick sourcing project, that system will navigate us to this screen. And here we have to configure that our bidding set. Basically here we have to do our bidding setup. So we can see here we have the five step, that is rule step, team, supplier, content, and summary. So basically in the rule step that we have to like determine that when our bidding window will be open and what will be the timing period that something window will be open to for the bidding process by the supplier. That's something we can like we can configure here. And some of the other optional like bidding rules are also available. Like if you want to use the scoring part and if you want to use the allow pricing, like a different pricing condition part, that's something those information we can configure here. Same way, currency conversion rules is also available here. So in case if you want to provide these options like of the currency conversion rule, we can like configure these things from here. So basically, this currency conversion rules is applicable in case of like you know like that like overseas bidding. So if our buying organization they are like doing the business with some like overseas vendor, in that case we can like set this currency conversion rule so that the buyer like the supplier who is like in the overseas, so they will be able to submit their bids in their local currency. But when that bidding amount will receive by the buyer will also be able to see in their local currency. So that's something if required, we can set up some currency rules here. And after setting this information, we have to move to the team tab. And in the team tab, whatever team member is required for this like sourcing event, that's something we can assign. And it's up to us, like either if some like a team members is required. For example, we can see some of the different team members are the like a default here. So we can see like global observers, surrogate bidder. So if required, we can assign any of the team members here. And if that's not required, we can skip. These are the optional. So it's up to the completely business they want to use. Guys, anyone have any questions? Jati?
When we create this a quick project, can we make sure we put the surrogate bidding and the pricing conditions so we can just see how that all works?
Okay, surrogate biddings might be we can see, but this pricing condition we may not see because, as I said earlier, like only enabling this pricing condition will not work. So if that our business they would like to use pricing condition, we also have to enable some parameter, and those parameter access we do not have. That's something we have to reach to the SAP Ariba to enable that parameter. Okay, So in even the server bidding also, so these are the like options are available, but by default it will not be the enabled. So first of what we have to do, like if we have to, like if the customer they wants to use, only in that case we have to enable. All right. So might be server biddings, I may not show you this one as well, because you know that we have the system constraint here. So we require the some two different system to show the server biddings, so, like how the server bidding works. But I will show you that normal bidding. So how that like a supplier is submitting like their bids against the sourcing project, that's something I'll show you.
But surrogate bidding is buyer doing it for the supplier, right?
Yes.
So it's on this system itself. I mean, on the buyer side, right?
Yes, that is fine. Yes, this will be everywhere in the system itself. Basically, not in this system. So generally, what is happening, like, you know, that in the surrogate biddings, the buyer will have the authorization of the supplier side as well. So what he will do, he will use the supplier like a credential and just to log in that supplier portal and just to submit the bids. From buyer itself, buyer side itself, they will not be like able to submit the surrogate bidding. So in that case also, they have to go to the supplier portal itself. But they will have the authorization.